everybody, we're out here in the pits at the NHRA looking for cool cars, and we have found yet another one. Check this one out. Chad Langdon, Mopar guy, E-Stock Automatic. Chad, tell us about your ride. What is it? How long have you had it?
It is a 1970 Plymouth Barracuda. I've had it approximately 8 years. I bought it from my brother in 2016. He's had it since 1976. Bought it from John Irving and Mike Loeb. They bought it at an auction, so they're still racing today. My brother, unfortunately, is not with us anymore. He passed away with a brain aneurysm in July of last year. So he's not being able to enjoy all the fruits of my labor here.
Or maybe he is.
Maybe he is.
Yes, you know, and so the car is obviously beautiful, and we love seeing you out there, a great racing family. But to be able to take something that was your brother's and come out here and do it and kind of keep that family energy going, like, to me, that's what this whole thing is all about.
Oh, it is. It is. And when this came up for sale, I said, absolutely, I want to buy it. Yeah, I told him. And I said, I used to sit in this car when I was a kid and pretend I was racing it when he first had it, you know, and then I'd clean it for him and polish it because, you know, we all live together and at home in Garden Grove, California, is where we all grew up.
So. Oh, my goodness.
But like I said, it's just been a lifelong dream to own this car because this was his idol. We thought for sure we were going to – we thought for sure he was never going to get rid of this car. And when, like I said, he decided to sell it, I said, let me figure out how I can do this, but I want this car. And we worked it out.
Oh, that is amazing. So tell us a little bit about the combination – 340, that's that high compression engine. We've seen a couple of them.
Yes.
That run an E.
Yeah. It is, like I said before, it's originally a 1970 Plymouth Barracuda, but I run it as a 71 because I like the bigger carburetor. A lot of people love the smaller carburetor, but right now this one's working for me. I just love it. And so I've converted it over to a 71, which isn't much. It's had taillights and grill, and you know, the intake manifold and carburetor is the only thing different. The motors are pretty much identical from 70 to 71.
And I think that's something interesting. We're showcasing the cars, and hopefully there are a lot of people think, oh, man, that car's awesome. But to run in stock Eliminator, they make sure that you abide by those things. So you might have to switch out some parts and pieces to make sure the car is what you say it is.
Yeah. And just to add something else, the car was originally a 4-speed car, but I don't run it, obviously, that way. You know, we run the 904 trans from ProTrans out of Waco, Texas, you know, the Smiths out there. You know, it's all good stuff. You know, it's running a little off right now. We've got something in the motor that's just not right, but we got a new one coming. It's at the balance.
Oh,
so this one's going to be good.
We're getting a last look at this one. Can we see under the hood?
Absolutely.
All right, let's do it. Let's get under the hood here with Chad Langdon's Barracuda. Oh, honey hush.
There it is. This is the high compression, like Joe said, the high compression 71340. It's a factory 10.25 compression, but we guessed to be about a little closer to 11 with it all blueprinted and everything. So.
No, it's sweet. A lot going on in the carburetor there.
Yep. That's, you know, they only did those for, well, pretty much all the 70s. All the Chryslers had those, the four-barrel cars. So, you know, those are hard to come by. This particular carburetor was built by Brad Van Lant along with the cylinder heads. He's out of Missouri. He's pretty much one of the gurus for these 340s. So, got to know who to go to.
You do. Yes. You have to know who to go to. Yes. And it's expertise, right?
Yes.
And these guys have been doing it for so long. Yes. But also, obviously, got a lot of modern stuff with the electric water pump and everything. I just love how, you know, well thought out and clean it is.
Yes.
Under the hood and fuel system.
I've had a lot of help from my father-in-law's family business is Clay Smith Cams. And my wife, Sherry, has been an integral part of that. And he's definitely helped put this thing together. And we've run real good with it. And we've been going rounds here lately, so.
Mr. Horsepower.
Right.
Do they sell more parts or do they sell more T-shirts and logos, right? The Mr. Horsepower logo is as iconic in drag racing as anything gets.
It is. It's been around. In fact, we're probably about 93 years, I think, Clay Smith Cam's been going.
Yeah.
And like I said, they've owned it. The Striegel family's owned it since 1967.
Amazing. All right, we want to see you in your office.
Okay.
Get in there.
Right.
Get in there. Obviously, we're going to want to hear it fire up. Stock Eliminator cars end up on attention in the pits very often because they're the real car, right? Like you got car, muscle car enthusiasts that are out there. They love these cars. There's Mopar shows going on every single weekend. But why wouldn't you want to come out to the NHRA and watch these cars in their natural habitat? All right, Chad, tell us about how you your procedure. You mentioned you go rounds, and that is so vital that you're out here turning on wind lights. You got a kid who's pretty good at this thing.
Yeah,
as
he's
well.
He's all right.
He's okay, especially at this style of racing. You know, two-time Super Comp world champ, went on, won Top Fuel, has had great success.
And don't forget about the junior championship. So he's the only one that's done all three.
Proud papa right here.
Right there.
But walk us through your procedure.
Really, there's nothing. It's all hooked up to the key, just like stock factory. The fuel pump's hooked up there, so you can hear it come on. Fuel pump comes on. You give it a little squirt of fuel. Fires right up.
Chad Langdon's Barracuda. We've been eyeballing this car for a while, and now we got to get up close and personal and see it. Chad, thank you very much for sharing your car. Most importantly, the connection with your brother that continues on out there on the track.
He's right here, you know, hanging out with me. He's telling me when to hit the brakes and when not.
There you go. Well, thank you for sharing your car with us.
Thank you very much.
And that is why you come out into the pits here at the NHRA.
Thanks.